Hi friends, welcome back to ReactJS Zero to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn ReactJS from scratch. In the last video, I have explained about how we can render lists in React. And in this video, I'm going to explain about conditional rendering in React. Let's start. We may need to display different things depending on different conditions. Conditional rendering is a term to describe the ability to render different mockups based on different conditions. To explain this, I have created a new React application in which I have created a component and I am using that in the app component. In this component, I have created two buttons and I am having a state called box color and I am defaulting that to red. And on clicking these buttons, I am changing the state. And I have created two divs. First one is having the class as red box and the second one is having green box. I have already added some CSS styles to these classes and so we can see this. Now both the boxes are displaying, but I want to display the red box and on clicking the green button, I need to hide the red box and show the green box. That means based on the state value, we are going to display different JSX elements. This is conditional rendering. Let's see how we can do that. First, let's try a simple if-else approach. For that, let me create a new function. Inside this function, if box color is equal to red, let me return this JSX. And otherwise, let me return this. And let me call this function here. And so, initially, red box is displayed, and if I click green button, we can see the green box. Similar to if else, we can also use switch case. Let me quickly comment this and rewrite to a switch case. And so we can see this is also working. Now let me use a ternary operator like this. So this is also working. And another advantage of going for ternary operator is, instead of having this inside a function and call that function here, we can directly use the ternary operator here, like this. This will also work. Also, instead of this, we can split this and render like this. So this is also working. And even shorter, we can use the logical AND operator to render like this. This will also work. Okay, let's add one more requirement to this. Let me add a 2-pixel border to these buttons. Now I want to change the border color to blue for the active button. Initially, red button is active, and so it should have the blue border. And when I click green button, that should have the blue color border. For that, let me add a class called active. And let me change the border color inside that class. Now we need to find a way to apply the class name to the active button. Actually, we can follow the same approach like how we rendered these boxes divs conditionally. So let me copy this and paste it here. And let me cut this and paste inside both the conditions. For the first one, let me add the active class name here. And for the second one, let me add that here. Now we can see the blue border in the red button. When I click the green button, it is getting the blue border. So it is working. But this approach is a little lengthy. I don't like this approach. Let me show you another approach. Let me copy these buttons. And instead of hardcoding the active class name, I can use ternary operator and show the active class name if the condition matches. Let me do the same for the other button as well. Now we can see it is working. But this time we are not conditionally rendering the entire button element. We are conditionally changing the class name only. But the problem here is, if the number of classes I wanted to show always is more, and I wanted to show few classes based on condition, then we need to rewrite all these classes in both the conditions of the ternary operator. Instead, we can use a ternary statement inside a template literal. Like this. This will also work. This is the simplest approach. Hope you understood how you can conditionally render elements and class names. Let me suggest a task. You can create a navigation like this. When this link is clicked, this content should be shown. If this link is clicked, we have to show this content. Also, please note that the active tab is also highlighted. Try this. If you need the solution code, you can take it from this GitHub repo. The link is available in the description. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe my channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.